This assembly line may not seem much different from any other modern vehicle assembly lines anywhere in the world. The difference there is not in the line itself, but in the vehicles being produced. They are all electric.
我们E6纯电动汽车的前舱只有副车架和电机的一个总成的装配，在传统的燃油车呢，除了副车架以外，还有发动机、变速箱及其他一些辅件，所以新能源的纯电动汽车呢，会比传统的燃油汽车装配会少很多的装配工序。
Making new energy vehicles is changing the traditional concepts of automobile manufacturing. High integration and modularization of components have become the trend. With its global lead in battery technology, this enterprise has shifted the focus of its business to new energy vehicles and become a major supplier of electric buses, providing new energy vehicles for more than 200 cities in 48 countries. Besides batteries, another core component of new energy vehicles is becoming a battleground for global producers. Dr. Tsai Wei knows now this is a big moment for Chinese vehicle manufacturers.
从这个角度上讲，电动车真是比发动机的车强。Tsai
Wei and his engineering team are going to test how their independently developed motor performs on road.
And has put China at the leading edge of new energy vehicles. In Shanghai, Dr. Tsai's factory is busy working on producing the new generation of motors. During the first stage of development in China's manufacturing industry, low labor costs and product prices provided China with its competitive edge in the global market. Now this manufacturing industry is undergoing a major transformation and upgrade. In future, manufacturing processes that are dull and repetitive will be handled by robots, leaving humans to supervise or engage in more creative work. Shenyang in northeast China is a center for robotic development. Here they design robots for a variety of different roles. They will be at the cutting edge of the production lines of the future. The robotics industry in China is expanding by 20% year on year.
它可以做好多人的体能、人的能力所不及做不了的事情。它在这个工业生产中解放了人类，把原来工人不愿意干的又脏又累又危险，甚至枯燥的工作呢，那么把人解脱出来，让人干更有创造性的工作，能有精力去进行改进、去改进升级。
A new production line comes into service. It's robots building robots. A master robot selects the designated parts on the shelf and transfers the parts to their correct positions on the flow line through automatic guided vehicles, AGV. Then robot arms assemble the parts. The line can build several different types of robot with complete precision. The rapid development of the industry has given birth to more and more types of robot. Engineers in Shanghai are working on the development of the next generation. Liu Yifan and his team is going to test the limits of their newly developed machines. Their new robot is going to carve an image on the shells of raw eggs. The eggshell is just 0.3 millimeters thick, while the surface of each egg is different. To engrave these irregular surfaces with a fast rotating cutting tool and avoid cracking the shell, the robotic arm must have precise control over its movement and have sophisticated spatial perception.
鸡蛋雕刻的主要难点在于如何在这么小的鸡蛋面积上刻出复杂的地图。这要求我们的位置精度非常非常的高。再一个，鸡蛋壳又薄又脆，非常小的位置波动或者是力波动都会破坏我们整个鸡蛋壳的一个结构。所以，整个雕刻过程中，对于位置控制和力控制的精度都是要求非常高的。
The key to this is this 7-axis robot. Compared with a traditional robot, this robot has 7 intelligently controlled rotation axes, which maximize the working parameters of the robotic arm. Working with multiple dimensions gives increased flexibility. A new robotic era is on the way. Mr. Li prepares to start the engine of his red. from 210 degrees Celsius to minus 180 degrees Celsius in a near vacuum state. It will operate in geostationary orbit 20,000 kilometers above the Earth, where no breakdowns are allowed. The potential of the BeiDou navigation satellite system is continually increasing. In the near future, wherever you are, no matter day or night, you and your smartphone will be under its watchful eye. It's 10 o'clock at night when train driver Zhang Zuni shows up for work.
开始试验件开始，44102293，44102293，输入正确。
His task today is to test a new high-speed train.
防滑试验。
In another couple of hours, it will take to the track for comprehensive testing.
紧急制动界面。空气自动可用，自动试验结束。
The train is part of a new series of high-speed trains called Fuxinghao, which literally means rejuvenation. Zhang Zuni will test the train in speeds of up to 350 kilometers per hour to verify the running conditions of the whole system.
启动确认。
There are 30 engineers on the train to monitor the test. In a few weeks, this new series of high-speed trains will take to the tracks for real as the world's fastest. Journey time from Beijing to Shanghai will be cut to 4.5 hours. As the rejuvenation series roll out across the whole network, China will usher in a new high-speed era. 1,500 kilometers away, in Changchun City, northeast China, the birthplace of China's heavy industry, a brand new factory has been commissioned. The first batch of the rejuvenation series is being assembled. They are wider, taller, and longer than the previous generation of high-speed trains, but their energy consumption is 15% lower. The trains are manufactured to uniform standards. Trains of the same type produced by other factories will all be compatible with each other. Even their components are compatible, which will help reduce running costs. At midnight, workers begin to install base plate bogies on number 5010 locomotive. It is the last element in the general assembly process. Base plate bogie supports the carriages and outputs power. This bogie is a new engineering design with a power output of 10,140 kilowatts. It has been tested over 600,000 kilometers each year for the last 3 years and has undergone 12 million fatigue tests. the bogey is about to be installed. It glides easily under the locomotive, pushed by two workers. Its positioning is determined by four pins, which are carefully married to the positioning holes. At 1 a.m., all the installation work has been successfully completed. China has the world's most complex natural environment. The new trains will face extreme cold, heat, and sandstorms, amongst other challenges. China has 60% of the world's high-speed track, which has carried more than 7 billion passengers. With higher efficiency, longer service life, and higher energy efficiency, China's high-speed trains are beginning to become the new standard for high-speed train travel.